Thank you. I would like to thank the organizer of the conference for the possibility to speak in this conference. Thank you. Okay. The topic of my report is pre-abelian trioids. The notion of trioid was defined by Lade and Ronka at the study of ternary planary trees. Recall that an algebraic system T with three associative operation is called a trioid if for all x, y, z from T, the following condition, conditions hold. It should be noted that trioids are generalization of diamondoids, which we introduced by Lade, and semigroups. What diamondoid is? An empty set T with two binary associative operation is called a diamondoid if T satisfies the axioms T1, T2, and T3. That is first three axioms, trioid axioms. Now, diamondoids and related algebras have been studied in many papers and play a prominent role in the Leibniz algebras theory. In addition, diamondoids are exceptions of semigroups. In this talk, we consider three objects in the variety of so-called abelian trioids. First, we note that the construction of a free trioid was defined in paper Lade and Ronka for a unit rank only. Later, this result was transferred for an arbitrary rank by Anatoly Zhuchok and Ulser for arbitrary rank and for monogenic case. In this direction, there are different results. For example, the endomorphous monoid of the free trioid of rank one, some congruence of the free trioids, free abelian monogenic D groups, free abelian D bands, free abelian diamondoid, and other problems were investigated. In this talk, we consider the property of abelianity in trioids and describe the structure of free abelian trioids. Okay. Take arbitrary trioid with the condition x on y is equal to y on x for two distinct operations on this trioid and for all xy from t. In this case, all operation of this trioid obviously coincide. If you take two identities from the following three, one, two, three, then two suitable operation of this trioid will coincide too. So for example, if we have first and second identities, then such operation coincide. So it's natural to introduce the following definition of abelianity in trioids. We fixed two trioid operation, distinct operation, and we call a trioid T abelian with respect to the fixed operation. If for all x, y from T, we have such condition. Here we note that here we consider only abelian trioid with respect to first two operation, such operation, and refer to them as simply abelian trioids. Further, we give some examples of such algebras. We take arbitrary semigroup and dual semigroup to S. We recall what left commutative semigroup is. semigroup S is left commutative is if it satisfies such identities. And proposition one, if you take arbitrary right commutative semigroup and dual semigroup to S, then such algebras are abelian trioids. And below dual case. Next example, we take arbitrary semigroups and define on this semigroup two binary operation on S. First operation define as left zero semigroup on S, and second operation define as right zero semigroup. In this case, we obtain example of an abelian trioid. Further, let D be an arbitrary abelian diamondoid. What is abelian diamondoid? Diamondoid is abelian if we have first condition holds for LXY from diamondoid. In this case, we obtain more two examples of abelian trioids. The next example, take additive commutative semigroup S and N subsemigroup of S, where N is more than two, and S alpha is equal to S for some alpha. By S we star, we denote the direct product of semigroup S G. And for all S from S we star, we put S plus is equal to such sum. Further, we define three operation on the set S V star by the rules. And proposition four says that for every alpha from such set, the algebraic system S V star we saw defined three operation is an abelian trioid. And last example of abelian trioid in this section, let S be an arbitrary semigroup and T a commutative semigroup for which there exists a gamma morphism from S into T. Further, we define on the direct product S on T three operations by the rules, and we obtain such example of an abelian trioid. This trioid we denote by S on T from Xi. This construction used for free abelian construction trioid. Okay, in the next section, we construct the free abelian trioid of arbitrary rank. Let X be an arbitrary non-empty set and N the set of all natural number. We denote by F from X and FCM from X, the free semigroup on X and respectively free commutative monoid on X. By star, we denote the homomorphism from free semigroup FX into free commutative monoid on X, which induces the last commutative semigroup congruence on the free semigroup F from X. Now we can define three binary operation on the direct product FX on FCMX. This set we denote by FATX. And we have the following result. This result is one of the main results of this talk. The algebraic system FAT from X with so defined three operation is a free abelian trioid. We note that this free abelian trioid is determined by of cardinality of X. It means that automorphism group of free abelian trioid is isomorphic to the symmetric group on X. Okay, then we specify the construction of the free abelian monogenic trioid. For this, we take additive semigroup of all negative integers and monomorphism eta from n with addition into n with zero with respect to addition. And by proposition five, here is proposition. It follows that algebra n on n with zero from eta is an abelian trioid. Moreover, according to proposition six, this trioid is isomorphic to the free abelian monogenic trioid FATX, where X is singleton. Below we can see isomorphic mapping between these trioids. Okay, and last section devoted the description of the least abelian congruence. That is congruence on free trioids such that quotient trioid by this congruence will isomorphic to free abelian trioid. Okay, a congruence rho on a trioid T is called abelian if the quotient trioid T by rho is abelian. And if we have a trioid homomorphism F, then corresponding congruence on T1 will be denoted by delta F. Further, for formulation, the second result, we need in definition of the free trioid. We recall that construction of free trioid was defined by Lade and Dronka. Okay, take arbitrary set X and copy of X, X with line, and let FTX with plus be the free semigroups on the union X with line. We denote the subsemigroups of FT plus X, which is subset of words containing at least one element of type X with line by FTX. And we introduce such denotation for every W from FTX, W with tilde. It means what obtained from W by replacing each X with line by X, X with line by X. And now we can define three binary operation on FTX in the following way. And proposition seven says that the algebra FTX with this operation is a free trioid. Okay, then we need a canonical form of elements from FTX. It's well known that every element from the free trioid can be represented uniquely in such way. V is equal such what, or V is equal in such form. Then we introduce two denotations for every W from FTX, the canonical form. Namely, theta from W is equal such what, and omega from W is equal such what or such what. In two cases, W is not equal theta from V, and W is equal to theta from V. And last denotation here, we denote by Q X with line from W, the quantity of all elements X with line that are included in the canonical form of what W. And now we can define a binary relation on FTX. Two words U and V from free trioid FTX we call sigma equivalent if for all X from big X the following conditions hold, two equalities here. Below we can see examples. And now we can formulate the second result of this talk theorem. The binary relation sigma is the least abelian congruence on the free trioid FTX. That is a quotient trioid FTX by congruence sigma is isomorphic to the free abelian trioid. Thus, we show as we can obtain free abelian trioid from free trioid by suitable factorization. And reference paper Lade, Ronka, and other also others. Thank you for attention.